about topics that I love a lot to speak about. So, so for me, again, it's really a pleasure. And so, well, this topic can be approached by many different ways. As I suggested, to put these subtitles on European experiences, because I would like to speak from a personal perspective, and you can find essays, articles, books, there are many of these topics. At the end of the talk, I will with a couple of my articles on this topic that I just uploaded to Academia, that is an open internet site where you can find them, because I've done them 1 or 2 years ago, one 2 years ago, and the other 10 years ago, but I had forgot to put them online. Now they are online, so you can watch them. So my experience is in some way double, because I started, my life changed when in 1999 I began to work as a consultant for this company that is called Luxvide. And then in the following year I started this program that is now the Master in International Screenwriting and Production. And both experiences, I say without any false humility or have been very successful in some way. So I will begin showing you a clip that was done 5 years ago by the company Luxvide. It's a 3 minute clip that is intended for international markets. So it says how we are good, how we have done good things, etc. So you will understand that and will excuse that. But it shows something that has been done by this company. And so we begin with this, and then we will go to some reflections, and at the end we go back to this specific experience of producing TV series and films with at least the attempt to be consistent with the Catholic point of view. So let's see if it works. Okay. Close this. Okay, double screen. For sure we check, because the technology always gives some problems. Okay, we are there. This is a trailer of different things, it's only 3 minutes.
Sometimes I justify the words I speak.
I give you my
word. I speak, take back words they spoke and kill.
You mustn't show no tricks, no cheating.
I'm sorry, my troubles are colder. But in these eyes, the melody is smolder. Let me show you one last time. Let me show you one last time. You can find it. I can say that I can change the world. But if you let me, I can make another world for us. Let me
such a
and you must leave us. What has happened to you? I don't know.
I must go on until I reach the land.
Fashion is in the sky. It's in the street. It has to do with ideas. Fashion is everywhere.
Most merciful God, welcome this man.
So, void you up.
Alexei!
Take it to Natasha, please.
Hello, dear.
I'm your
vuoi?
Mi chiamo Francesco Neri. Sono il nuovo capo della forestale.
Mi riconosci?
Hai fatto una cosa bellissima.
Senza te non avrei fatto nulla.
Ora trasmettiamo la 12ª e ultima puntata di Studio 1.
Vedi ci guardi, non spesso.
Aiuto!
Like secret angels.
A wonderful thing.
It's time to go
home. My troubles are over. But in your eyes, the melody's frozen.
Okay, so we will come soon to this experience, but let's start with something that we will go fast on this because I think it's very understandable. I told the last 40 years that which there have been big cultural changes, some positive aspects. Less poverty, less racism, more equality and dignity between men and women. There is less atheistic communism, more complex and controversial view of abortion by radicals. I think there's, at least in Europe, a little bit less ideology on this. But there's also some negative aspects. Euthanasia has become an issue in many countries, development of finance that goes against social justice. Individualism against solidarity, also in Europe, France and other countries, Spain, secularism, as it did, that in some countries become very aggressive, almost tyrannical. And also we have a big change in perception of love, marriage, family, and its nature in many countries in the world. Less people want to commit themselves in a marriage as an institution. Yes, to premarital sex and living together in a marital way without marriage. And also in some countries, yes, to civil life partnership, yes, to homosexual so-called marriage and adoption or children by homosexual couples, gender ideology. And we must admit that all these big changes has been really pushed by television and cinema, especially American and English media, which have a huge impact all over the world. In many, many countries in the world, American cinema is from 80% to 90-95% of the cinema that is watched in some countries. There are very few countries where it is less than 80% or 70%. So, for example, just to do an example, we could trace the history of acceptance and promotion of free relation on the homosexual lifestyle. Again, I go fast on this. Out of Africa, that could you could think a very nice film, very romantic, etc. The underlying theme is that love is pure if it is lived without bonds. And this, at the end of the day, is what they say in the film. Philadelphia was a very strong changing moment in favor of homosexual relations. We have 1993. Brokeback Mountain, that was not so a huge success in terms of box office, but had a very strong cultural impact. The Danish Girl, in Story of a Transsexual, this had again a very strong cultural impact. But obviously, we have also movies with a positive image of family. I don't mean that what was before is universal. And not by chance, I put here some things that have been also very successful, probably much more successful in terms of box office, but maybe with less cultural impact of the previous ones. Again, very short on something that I think is very clear. At the end of stories, there is an exploration of human life. We were speaking this at dinner with some new friends that I met today. Stories are like condensed and extremely powerful experiments of morality. The moral theme is the nucleus of the development of a good and successful story. Inside a story, there is an exploration of human life. And literature, cinema, and television are mass media that can reach an extremely large audience, but this is the crucial thing about mass media. The spectators, the audience, does not feel anonymous viewer. They feel deeply and intimately connected with the characters. So all these products, they are mass products, but they offer an intimate and personal relation to the viewers, although they are millions. This is the reason why a story well told can change a life. And it happens very frequently. I have a friend who is now very well known in Italy, said, well, he decided to be a teacher after watching Dead Poets Society. This changed his life. So the fact that popular stories create a personal connection because they appeal to emotions and reason, and also they reach a big number of people, especially TV and cinema, makes their impact on culture and on key human attitudes and decisions huge. This is why the topic we speak today is important. TV series make familiar what is sometimes unique, new, and exceptional in cinema. So also TV can change the perception of values. They can change societies. So I put here some titles of TV series that are directed especially to teenagers, young people. And if you know them, you can see how they are being more and more edgy and extreme in the representation of some aspect of the life of young people. So, also, we have to see that the source of the story that goes over the world is really a small community. The writers have just finished the strike, finishing the strike, and I don't know if you know how many are the writers in strike. There were 11,000. So all the writers that work for the American cinema and television are 11,000 people. So it's a very small percentage of people. If you add to them some creative producers, some directors, etc., you can end and maybe you cut this 11,000, half of them that probably they write only one episode or two episodes per year doing what other people ask. Probably the people who really matter are 500, 1,000, but there are very few, very few. This has never happened in the history of humankind. Few people could reach so many people all over the world. For example, Barbie now has a box office of $1,400 million. That means that it has been watched by in the theaters by more or less, let's say, 200 million people, 300 million people, something like that. And in few weeks, okay? It happened to me, we'll have a slide about that. So other than Hollywood, it's only regional, it's only local. Korea makes some TV drama for Asia, Japan makes comics and animation. India is huge, but only national. The films from India do not go abroad. China still is national. They are trying to become important. They are trying to become international, but for the moment they are not succeeding that. What happens with the big movies, Marvel movies, for example, is that
the necessity of appealing to audiences all over the world, especially when a film costs 200 million or 300 million, they cannot be too edgy because otherwise people don't go. So they have necessarily to be connected with the common experience and values of millions of people in the world. So you see that the big box offices normally are good in terms of values, Star Wars, Jurassic World, the Avengers, Spider-Man, etc. Although not very significant for culture in general. This is a big difference with television because having a completely other model of revenues, etc., they don't need to reach a high number of viewers. When HBO makes a show, they are happy if they have 1 million viewers or 1 million and a half. It's very niche because they are paid by the subscription. And so they have had in last year much more freedom to become extreme, to become very transgressive, to go against common values, changing perceptions and views. Made by a very small cultural minority, they have a strong cultural agenda. So here there are some titles and some images. Maybe you've seen some of that or you know some of that. The exceptions are not so many. Also, if there are exceptions, for example, I put one, but there are others. A one big success that is morally good or very good has been Downton Abbey, that is a huge success in UK, huge success in other countries, critical acclaim when it was released here in PBS. I think it made four times the usual audience that they do in PBS. Many Emmys won. I show this simply because it shows that another way is possible if you do things well. Here is a book of that appeared more or less, let's say, 10 years ago with interviews to producers, writers, etc., that showed very well that they had a cultural agenda or political agenda, you can call it as you like. And there is a whole story, again, we will go fast on this, that started with the authors of TV of the 50s. Big names like Simon Bell Brooks, Woody Allen, Caroline, Larry Gelbart, and then others. And in recent years, Stephen Boschko, John Wells, Greg Berlanti, and Sorkin. This doesn't mean that they are not good. Aaron Sorkin has done the West Wing, that is, in my opinion, a very good series. In last years, as we know, there has been an explosion of production and availability of content, there is much more, and the production, especially in the US, has been more than double than years ago. Last year, I think they have been producing 600 TV series. So it's a huge number. So to finish this section, the TV series a cinema fraud for being anti and trivial entertainment are the result of a creative investment that is huge. For example, I don't know if you have ever considered that a season of The Simpsons now is a little bit down, but they said for many years, it's more than 30 years that this TV series is going on. Every season of 22 episodes is written by 15 top screenwriters. That means that in 1 year, every one of them has to write what is needed for 30 to 35 minutes of finished product. That means that if he writes 1 page per week is okay. 1 page per week. This obviously they don't do like this. They do brainstorming for ideas, for episodes, etc. But at the end of the day, if you divide the work, one page, the pages of scripts are also have a lot of blank space, one page per week or less than that. So this gives you an idea of how much is the investment, the creative investment on this kind of shows. Which can be the answer to the situation from the point of view of Catholics or Christians or believers? I think that the answers are always on different levels. And I think that there are two areas. One is the area of every one of us as a viewer or as an intellectual, as a professional. So it's the area of the education of taste, intelligence, and feeling, finding and proposing good content, and there is good content. You can find it if you look for it. There is abundant good content, especially now that with all this platform, you can approach also TV series from many countries in the world. But for sure, there is good content also in American TV, in American TV series, in American cinema. And for the future, training professionals of the entertainment. This is something that I consider a key point. So, find good content, let's go fast on this. The good things obviously can have a positive educational impact, good TV series. Also because they help to open the minds and to understand much better the human condition. So they can have a positive educational impact also for lawyers, doctors, medical doctors, business people, and all this kind of stuff. So an educator must find instruments and time to know them and to find them and also use them. And there are good international TV series, Newsroom, Band of Brothers, Sherlock, CIS, many. So I put some other here, Lupin, The Crown. Lupin, for example, has been very, very successful. It's one of the top TV shows on Netflix. And also, I don't know if you've seen some of the HTs, The Queen's Gambit, The WandaVision, The Mandalorian, Cobra Kai, The English Game, This Is Us, almost. In the specific experience on which in the last minute of my talk I want to speak is the experience that I've been doing the last 25 years as a script consultant for LuxVideo, for this company, because it was a challenge at the beginning. The company was founded by a man that was in his 70s, he had just retired from being the emperor of Italian television from 60 to 74. Italian state television, that was the only television that we had at the time. So the show had half of the population that watched the shows. Then from 74 to 92, he had other jobs. He was the president of a big holding for different things. You see that, but retiring in the 70s, he said, what is needed now from our society? And it was a moment in which everyone wanted to open new channels, so Catholics wanted to open new channels, but I say, no, what is needed is good content for all the channels that will be open now and in the future. So he created this production company with the idea, he said like this, to say that the man is a creature of God. And to insist on this, and this company has been very successful, and has created also some content that is not only general content. Like you see, this series Doc Mutonani is a series that came out in 2020. It had 8 million viewers every night, and it was sold to more than 100 countries, being paid, and it was a Italian production. It was completely paid by the Italian network, that is the state television, that paid for that. So it was not a big international project that costed a lot of money, but it was very, very successful. And but besides this, this company did also some miniseries with a, let's say, explicit religious content. You've seen some short clips, short scenes in the trailer, but we had done the life of Saint Augustine, Saint Philip Neri, Mother Teresa. We have done books. You've seen John Paul II, but there is also a Pius XII, John the 23rd. For example, John the 23rd is interesting. It's still the miniseries in Italy, the most watched TV product in the last 25 years. It had 51% of share and 15 million of viewers in a country of 60 million. So it's like if in US you have more or less 80 million viewers. So one can ask, well, another, you've seen some images also of a TV series that is called Don Matteo. We will see that. We will adapt to that. Let's go to another slide. Here are some good TV series that are in Italy. The problem is today in many countries the content for teenagers, because there is good content available for children, but it's important to do things also for that audience, that specific audience. So, as we said, the presence of people with a correct anthropological view have been a very small minority in many, many, many countries. So, to prepare the future, what does it mean? It means a serious reflection about our way of communicating and promoting our values. For example, the importance of the use of stories in different situations, in different, not only in cinema and television. Because stories communicate to the mind and to the heart, and you cannot reach people deeply if you do not connect with their emotions. I've been in a conference a few days ago, there was the screenwriter of Inside Out that you see here. It was very interesting to hear and to talk with her.